Hi, my name's Rani Hasan, and I'm an interventional cardiologist at Johns Hopkins and a member of our structural heart disease program at the Johns Hopkins Hospital here in Baltimore, Maryland, and at the Suburban Hospital in Bethesda, Maryland. I specialize in the treatment of valvular heart disease, that is, problems of the heart valves and their function, as well as other problems with the heart's structure and function. Our structural heart disease program is a multidisciplinary team comprised of cardiologists, cardiac surgeons, anesthesiologists, radiologists, nurse practitioners, and other specialists and support staff who work together to treat patients with heart valve problems and other sometimes complicated heart disease. Members of our team have different areas of expertise and skills that we bring together to help evaluate patients and come up with the most appropriate and individualized treatment options for each patient. My research focuses on the impact of frailty and delirium on how patients fare after they have major cardiovascular procedures. Specifically, we're interested in seeing how minimally invasive transcatheter aortic valve replacement may actually improve patients' frailty status and help us avoid delirium and other complications that are often related to more invasive approaches. For example, we have found that by using moderate sedation for transcatheter aortic valve replacement and hence avoiding the need for general anesthesia, we can avoid the risks associated with general anesthesia, such as delirium and other problems related to cognition and memory. I came to medicine because I have a passion for science, and I wanted to use science in a way that I could help people, really at an individual level, not just with broad brushstrokes. I came specifically to cardiovascular medicine really for two reasons. Number one, I was fascinated by cardiovascular physiology. That is, the way the heart and the circulatory system work. Secondly, I found the evaluation and treatment of cardiovascular problems to be exciting and fulfilling. From being able to make a diagnosis by simply listening to my patient and using a stethoscope, to being able to effectively treat problems that are often life-threatening and at least life-altering, and being able to restore my patient's health and well-being. I came to Johns Hopkins to complete my medical training, and I decided to continue my career here because of the people, because of the amazing group of individuals from all different walks of life and backgrounds who are committed to improving the lives of each of our patients.